Hello, 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 hello! It is I, 8-Bit, your favorite chicken nugget VTuber. And I'm freaking tired. Oh my god. Oh, I did not get to bed until 4 a.m., 4:30. Oh my god. But I am here, as promised. A little past 10 a.m., but that's pretty close. To start my 8.5 hour Kingdom Hearts stream. Woo! God. No, I actually am very excited about this. I am just tired right now. So we're gonna do just a little bit of just chatting for like 10-ish minutes. Just to wake myself up. Oh my god. Enjoying the sunny area of Destiny Islands behind me. With papu fruits, plenty. Children fighting with their wooden swords. It's truly a hidden hideaway. Actually, it sounds like something from Peter Pan when I described it like that. We will be experiencing Peter Pan, because this is Kingdom Hearts. As you know, there is a shit ton of Disney worlds mixed with Final Fantasy. At the very least in the early games, because we will be starting with Kingdom Hearts 1. Because as you know, today begins my journey to getting the Unchanging Equipment Trophy. Something that has eluded me in the past because of my own stupidity. Honestly, there's no other way to put it than stupidity. I read the trophy listing when I was playing this game years ago, and it didn't dawn on me when it says do not change equipment. That means I shouldn't add equipment either. So here we are, years later, about to do it for you guys as a thank you for, before 2020 ended, getting me past 75 followers. Seriously, guys, you are amazing. I love you all. And now I'm about to suffer for you all. There's no way I'm going to be getting the trophy today, because I doubt I could beat Kingdom Hearts in 8 hours. Especially with the beginning Keyblade only. But, you know, I'm hoping to make some good progress today. That's the goal. That is the main goal. The gooly woolly bully. Ravioli. I am also tired, Brian, so this is gonna be a heck of a time. Now, just a couple things to note before we start. There is a new channel point redeem, if you'll notice. Actually, let me see if I can look at it from here. Yep. It's the same price as an Ada Ada. There will be, you spend 1,000 channel points during a Kingdom Hearts stream only. This is only redeemable when I'm playing the game. So not yet. Please do not redeem it yet. I am so tired to do it now. But I will be doing a, you redeem 1,000 channel points from 1 minute exactly. I gotta pull a timer up when I do it. I am forced to do a, like, kind of South Park Mickey Mouse, oh-ho! Kind of impression while I play the game for exactly a minute. So for 1,000 channel points, you can hear Mickey Mouse the Nugget play Kingdom Hearts. This surely will not get spammed at all. Right, chat? I have no faith in any of you. You're going to make me suffer. That is why I'm playing this game to begin with. That makes me sound like I hate Kingdom Hearts. And I kind of do to an extent, but I actually still really love Kingdom Hearts. I just hate where the franchise went after Birth by Sleep. I think Birth by Sleep was the last one I like truly loved. But I mean, I still love Kingdom Hearts as a franchise in general. I mean, there was a lot of good memories of it in the past. I mean, Man, I do have a lot of feelings when it comes to Kingdom Hearts. Mostly good, but recently not so much, because those feelings are kind of mixed with Kingdom Hearts 3 and how the story went, but I still really actually do love Kingdom Hearts. So, I kind of want to actually... Sorry. Hang on. Sorry about that. Had to blow my Widow Nugget nose. What nose? I have a nose. Na-na-na-na-na-na-na. You just can't tell. But anyway, so since this is kind of on topic, I'm gonna relate it to Kingdom Hearts. So I kind of want to actually talk briefly about this adorable anime I watched not that long ago, Komi-san Can't Communicate. Probably never heard of it before, ever. Probably never heard of it ever. I promise this will tie back in. It follows the best non-cat cat girl, Komi-san. The most popular girl at her school who is so crippled with social anxiety that the idea of speaking makes her jitter like crazy. In like an adorable way, though. Like, any attempt at socializing just ends with, I cannot speak today. Like, any attempt at her, like, talking to anyone just ends up with her going, duel! Sorry, I had to sneak a Yu-Gi-Oh joke in there. But the reason why I like the anime so much is because of its whole premise that she's trying to move past her social anxiety step by step with the first guy that actually really reached out to her and saw past her radiant glow and wants to help her make 100 friends, which is such a wholesome goal to want to achieve. And the reason why I'm talking about this anime is it kind of hits home with me personally, because growing up for quite some time, I never really spoke to my teachers, like in elementary school, because of my social anxiety. I didn't really do many presentations. I mean, it didn't last like forever. I mean, I eventually got over it. But it was like a difficult time trying to make friends when I was a little kid, and it kind of like relates to me now, because now I'm streaming. It's almost like I'm trying to kind of make up for lost time by constantly talking your guys' ear off. So that's really why I like enjoyed the anime, because I felt like a relatable connection to Komi-san, as much as probably a lot of other people do. Minus, you know, the abject praise and the more, why don't you shave your unibrow? Because I am small to hold a razor, damn it! Back off, I was just a kid! Now to tie this conversation back to Kingdom Hearts is, I didn't really have like that many friends growing up, besides like my brother. And I especially, like, played games like Kingdom Hearts with him. I mean, I know it's a JRPG, but you really just play by yourself. But, you know, like, you play games in front of your sibling, you know, you have a good old time. And then, like, the magical power of, like, Kingdom Hearts was, like, just the idea of being able to traverse many different kinds of worlds that normally don't have anything to do with each other. And just creating a whole new kind of story out of it. And that kind of like inspired like my creative side when I was younger. I used to come up with all sorts of random Kingdom Hearts fanfics and shit in my head that was just in my head that I used to act out or just put it on paper for no one to see. And that always kept me busy despite everything until I actually became more confident in myself. And, so for better or for worse, I owe a lot to the Kingdom Hearts franchise for really kind of keeping me sane and happy for a good amount of my time as a kid. So, no matter what, I still remember Kingdom Hearts fondly. I really do. And I still love, like, the original games. Kingdom Hearts 2 is still my favorite game. It's one of my favorite games, not my favorite game. My favorite game is Persona 3. For different reasons. Aha, see, I told you I would tie it back to Komi-san. Or Komi-san back to Kingdom Hearts. How am I gonna stream for 8 hours today? Gee willikers, Batman. Let's see. I guess I didn't really put up text for it. Let me see if I can add that right now. But there will be a follower goal, as you know from my announcement video. If I hit 202 followers before I beat this game, which won't be today, I can guarantee it won't be today, but it will be before February ends, I will do that 4-hour Sephiroth challenge. Where I do the Sephiroth boss fight with just the Kingdom Key. I don't want to do that, honestly, because I've never beaten Sephiroth normally. But, you know, we'll do what we can. Plus, it'll be entertaining for you guys, no matter what, more than likely. I mean, watching a poor, helpless Nugget suffer under the weight of his own lofty goals, what's not to love? Also, damn. Now, again, this will be going from 10 a.m. PST to about 6:30 PST, so about 8.5 hours. I think around like 2:30 or 3 is when I will take a... Oh no, I spilled water on my mat. Damn it. Crap. I knew that was gonna happen. I'll be taking probably like a 25 to 30 minute break during that time. I mean, I'll still be around, like, in my room and such, but I'll have the break screen on just to walk around a little bit and also have a little bit of a lunch. Don't worry, I've had breakfast, please. Don't worry about this Nugget is well fed. As fed as he can be. Okay, I think we'll go on for like one more minute and then we'll start the game. Let me just get some things ready and organized. I'm actually kind of excited and terrified. I've never done a stream this long before. Or like, I think one time in a past life I did before my nuggetiness. But I don't think that was ever recorded. So, this is gonna be like my first long, long stream. And I have to blow my damn nose again. I hate morning allergies. Also, I want to start on Destiny Islands because that's where we're going to be actually starting the game. And I just like the coziness vibe of the whole area. It's quite nice. And it's such a big focal point for like the entirety of Kingdom Hearts. Also, supposedly, it's the only instance where we see Sora's mother in the entire franchise. Then she's never mentioned again. Because we are to assume Heartless killed her. At least that's what I've always assumed. Because I mean, if Heartless attacked Destiny Islands, which is, you know, supposed to be a whole world, it's not like the island itself is like a separate world from like the town. At least that's how the logic is. Because I mean, Sora and the gang have to get to this island somehow. So, they had to have taken out all the villagers and stuff. Maybe that's why. Maybe Sora's too heartbroken to mention that his mother's dead. Huh. What a downer way to start this stream. And I don't think there's any better time than to just switch over to the game and get started. Alright, give me one second. Oh, I cut the music. Cut the music! For different, more soothing music. Alright, alright, alright. Okay. Oh, whoops. That just goes to show how much of a dumb brain I am. I forgot to put the damn game in. Ah, scuff stream. Let's go. Okay. Slide my disc in my PS5. Oh, actually, I'll bring this up here in a second. Yeah, to reposition myself. So, fun fact. I actually had to rebuy the entire Kingdom Hearts franchise because my PS3 is not really working with my discs anymore. Unfortunately. So that's fun. But luckily, the Kingdom Hearts franchise as a whole, all bundled together from 1 to 3, is actually fairly cheap. You can get it at most places for like $30 at most. Which is insane. Because you get, I mean, it's a good bang for your buck. It's like 10 games. Well, okay. 7 playable games and like 4 interactive movies. That you get for $30. It's actually not a bad deal. It also goes to show how Kingdom Hearts is valued now. Because I feel like it really went down price-wise after Kingdom Hearts 3. But we are going to be starting our Kingdom Hearts journey again here on my PlayStation 5. So why don't we, hippity-hoppity our way to it, shall we? Oh man, wouldn't that suck if I was muted for like 20 minutes? I totally thought I was for a second. Because I just looked over and the screen didn't look right. Not my OBS. Ah, here we go. Now, in order to get this trophy, I gotta beat the game. Not change equipment. Now, I could just play on easy. That'd give me a pretty good shot at doing it. But years ago, I attempted to get the trophy on normal, and I would have if I just didn't equip accessories. So, I think I'm gonna do it on normal again. Because all these trophies are new now. Because the PS4 version doesn't stack with the PS3 version. And I want to prove I am still a skilled nugget. That I can do normal mode again. Thinking of you wherever you are, chat. We pray for our sorrows to end and hope that our hearts will blend. Now I will step forward to realize this wish. Also, I didn't realize the rhyme at the beginning of that. Let's get a preview about our journey here. Yo, Zartoro! Hello! How are you doing, my man? We're just getting ready to start up Kingdom Hearts here. I'm tired. Trying to get motivated so hard today. Dude, I feel you. I got up at 8 after going to bed at 4. Cold weather sapping your energy? Oh, I feel that. Although, I'm not gonna lie, like I really actually do enjoy like the beginnings of winter. Because I actually like going outside. when it's cold out. I like seeing my breath in the air. I like the kind of cool chilliness on my, like, my face while being warm bundled up in some, like, thick clothes. I don't know. I love hoodies and stuff and sweaters. So it's kind of nice. But I am kind of... I'm looking forward to spring really badly. I kind of just want sunshine right now. Yeah, hoodies and jackets are, like, some of the comfiest clothing you can wear. I fuck with hoodies. I'm very much a hoodie guy. Ooh, I should get a little hoodie for my Nugget. I should get an Organization 13 hoodie for my Nugget. Oh, oh, that would be such a cool VTuber asset. Oh. Maybe if I play Kingdom Hearts 2 on stream, I'll do that. Which, yes, there is the possibility that I will play more Kingdom Hearts games in the future. But not anytime soon after this one. Hoodie drip is my aesthetic on characters. Hoodie drip works on almost anybody. Actually, no, I'll take that back. I don't think hoodie drip doesn't work on anybody. Like, everyone looks good in a hoodie. Throw a black hoodie on somebody, it works. Almost always works. Oh yeah, I forgot Bambi's a summon in this game. I think this is the only game where Bambi's in it. I don't think Bambi's in any of the future titles. Poor girl. I don't think I've ever seen Bambi in the movie. Like, all the way through. Like, I've seen the iconic scene, you know, that everyone talks and memes about, which, you know, sad. But I don't think I've ever actually sat down and watched Bambi all the way through before. Huh. Maybe I'm not as much of a Disney fan as I thought. Oh, well. Enough stalling. I have to play the game at some point. And that is not today! No, I'm kidding. I'm gonna do it. Here we go. Okay, Final Mix Beginner, Final Mix Proud. No fucking way am I gonna try and get this game. No way in hell I'm gonna try and get this trophy of not changing equipment on Proud mode. I'll just do regular Final Mix. Auto camera rotate. I'm thinking I'm going to stick with auto, but I might change that later. Yeah, sure. I like to vibrate. I like to go dee dee. Me. Okay, here we go now. Now remember, I cannot change equipment. I'm going to make multiple saves just to make sure I don't forget and screw that up. That is the whole point of me playing this game again. To get the trophy. But at the very least, we get to enjoy one of the best songs to ever come out of the Kingdom Hearts franchise. And relive my middle school days.
These weird thoughts lately. Like, is any of this for real? Or not?
Classic puberty thoughts. Are any of us real? Alright, here we go! Fucking, I love this song. Just in time, welcome Kitty! Riku. Riku was my favorite Kingdom Hearts character. I don't know if he still is. I haven't thought about it in a long ass time. I love this song. Mm-hmm. You walk away, you don't hear me say please. Oh baby, don't go. Okay, I'm not actually gonna try and sing the song because I'm a bad singer. I'm not gonna do that. Or I can try and sing it badly. But seriously, this was like every middle schooler's like jam growing up. Down for Nugget karaoke? Nah, you're just down for Nugget. I'm sorry, but no. No. I don't think I can do a karaoke stream. You're not wrong. Oh, kitty. Also, hoping you have a fantastic morning. Also, I actually just realized hopefully that song is fine to have on Twitch. I'm just gonna assume it is. Yeah. I didn't say karaoke stream, just karaoke. When you walk away, you don't hear me say, please, oh baby, don't go. And you'll be cleaning the way you make me feel tonight. There you go. There you go. There's your karaoke. So much to do, so little time. Take your time. Don't be afraid. I am afraid, though. There's Snow White just staring at me. The door is still shut. Now step forward. Can you do it? No. Start. Got breakfast and decided to load up your favorite nugget. Aw, thank you so much. All right, taking our first steps to the remainder of our streams this month. And just like that, put to a stop. And it's over, folks. Good night. Power sleeps within you. If you give it form, it will give you strength. Choose well. Okay, this is actually something I need to think about. Because I'm doing this with only the beginning equipment. I feel like I should prioritize strength because my Keyblade is going to be very dull and not do shit against later bosses for a while. So if I prioritize strength, that means hopefully my attacks will get stronger. Hup. Power of a warrior, invincible courage, a sword of terrible destruction. This is the power you seek. Yes. Also, seriously, that's actually a really, like, neat-looking sword. I like the Mickey Mouse symbol in the middle. Like, I'm kind of sad that's not an actual prop you can get. I'm sure you can make it, but still. Now, will you give up in exchange? I need defense, but magic would be very useful. I actually don't remember how impactful these decisions are. Hey, look, a turtle. I think I've watched Snow White once in my life, so I don't even remember many of the characters besides, like, the dwarves and, like, Snow White herself. And obviously the witch that poisons her. The power of the mystic. Inner strength. Staff of wonder and ruin. You give up this power? But magic's actually